The statistics are staggering. In 2013, just shy of 700 people were killed nationwide in crashes involving red light running.
And we do have national video just released today. We'll see red light runners here in the metro, it seems like every day.
And today, our Erin Murray set up at some intersections, and she says it didn't take long to see some coast right through on red.
It happens every day at intersections. The light turns from yellow to red, and then this. Someone runs the light trying to get through. Watch one more time here at 84th and Dodge. This Jeep Cherokee runs right in front of an OPD officer. The officer followed, but we never saw them turn their lights on. Wednesday, our crew watched many cars run red lights. Here's another at 90th and Dodge. Each one we witnessed. No one died, no one was hurt. But we all know it's only a matter of time.
It's kind of a miracle that I'm even still standing and walking.
Jillian Driver knows that firsthand. Last August, coming through the intersection at 78th and Sorensen, a driver ran a red light, crashing into her.
So I was going probably about 40. He was going faster than I was.
And the leading cause of car crashes in cities is actually people running red lights.
We see it happen around us every day. And the consequences when a crash does occur do not just last for a day.
I had a lot of back and wrist problems. I had to do physical therapy for a few months, and I'm actually still working with the insurance companies to get all of that stuff taken care of. It's been a year, and it's still not settled.
And while Omaha is far from the worst city with a red light problem, red light runners can be seen every day running red lights at most busy intersections.
Our own scary statistics today. Now, we stood at three intersections, one of them being here at 72nd and Dodge, and we stood at them for about 20 minutes each, and each intersection we stood at, we saw at least two cars in 20 minutes coast right on through red. Now, we did stand out here around 3:30 to 5, so rush hour, and that actually is the most frequent time to see people go right through red lights. Reporting live with photographer Brogan Ellis, Erin Murray, WOWT 6 News.
Thank you, Erin. And this week is National Stop and Go Week, a big campaign to urge drivers to, of course, be more aware and to not run those red lights.
In Nebraska, if you are caught, the average fine for running a stoplight or stop sign ranges between $100 to $300. And those fines do go up if caught in a school zone or construction zone.